Good afternoon. I introduce myself. I'm Ratiba Benzalga from ATR Lab, University of Renoir. I'm going to present you today our work on long carbon fibers loaded ultraporous epoxy composite for planar microwave absorber materials. Here is the outline of my presentation. First, I will present the context of this study by presenting the commercial absorber material and our proposed material. Then, in the second part, I will present the multi-layer absorber, starting with the elaboration method, then the influence of the elaboration parameter on the morphological structure, then the prototype achievement and characterization result. I will finish my presentation with the conclusion and perspective. Let's start with the context of our study. I start with this simple presentation of absorption principle. When an incident electromagnetic wave arrives on the surface of material, a part of this wave is reflected, a part is absorbed, and the last part is transmitted through the material. In the case of absorbing material, we need a low reflection, a low transmission, and a high absorption of the electromagnetic waves. The form and composition of the absorbers are various and depend on the targeted application. For the composition, we can find the magnetic or dielectric absorbers. In our case, we deal with this last type of absorbers, and we are looking for low permittivity in order to reduce the reflection and high dielectric losses for a high absorption and thus a low transmission. Absorbing materials are used in several fields of application, for example, stealth, in antennas, and for the protection of microwave circuits, and they are also used to realize anechoic chambers. Our targeted application here is the anechoic chamber. In this chamber, absorbing materials with probe and absorption are used. The thick absorbers are often needed to obtain broadband absorbers. For these absorbers, it is necessary to ensure a gradient of impedance to minimize the reflection of the waves at the interface air absorber. For this, we can use a physical gradient where the gradual impedance is obtained by varying the geometry of the material itself, or a gradient of properties by varying the composition of each layer, which is the case of multi-layer absorber. In this work, I will present this type of absorber. Today, absorbers used in the anechoic chamber are often as a form of pyramidal or multi-layers made of polyurethane foams loaded with carbon nanoparticles. The advantage of these absorbers are their low density, which facilitates their installation in the anechoic chamber, and their load carbon particles, which ensures a good absorption performance in wide frequency range. In addition, the frequency range and the performance of these absorbers can be adapted by varying the carbon content and dimensions of these absorbers. On the other hand, these absorbers have some disadvantage. First, the used loss, which is a volatile escape from the matrix and induces a nanometric pollution and the premature aging of this absorber. And the second one, the flexibility of this absorber increases machining errors and prevents the realization of complex shapes that can increase its absorption performance. In order to overcome the limitation of commercial materials, we propose to study new absorbing materials based on epoxy foam loaded with long carbon fiber. Here, the rigid foam permits the achievement of new and complex geometry for the optimization of absorption performance. This aspect is treated in my presentation on Friday at 9:15 a.m. On the other hand, carbon fibers are non-volatile load and their use guarantee good performance over time. But this proposed material presents high density, about 0.14 gram per centimeter cube, compared to commercial absorber with density of 0.07 gram per centimeter cube. So the objective of this work is to reduce the density of this composite, also to reduce the thickness of these absorbers, and to use a low amount of load, keeping the same absorption performance. So this is the topic of the second part of my presentation. I present here the elaboration method of the ultralight epoxy foam. First, we start with the pre-dispersion of carbon fibers of 12 mm length. These fibers are added to solution of acetone and SDS, which is a chemical dispersant, after which ultrasound is applied to disperse these fibers. Then the dispersed fibers are added to the epoxy resin. The whole mixture is put in the oven to evaporate the amount of acetone and to leave only the desired amount of acetone in the mixture. Then the foaming agent is added and mixed with the spatula. And this mixture is left at room temperature for 6 hours to finalize the foaming steps, then at 60 degrees to finalize the polymerization. Finally, the foam will be cut to be characterized. Now we will present the effluence of the acetone amount left in the resin on the structure of the foams. We can see clearly on this photo that the volume of the epoxy foam increases when the amount of the acetone increases to 15%. After that, the limit is reached at 20% of acetone. The optical and the same images show that the size of pores of epoxy foam increases when the amount of acetone increases. By varying acetone amount, we succeed to reduce the density from 0.14 for epoxy without acetone to 0.05 by using 15% of acetone. After this amount, the density increases because the foam structure is altered. In this part, I present the ultralight foam with 8% of acetone loaded with 0.075% of carbon fiber, compared to the standard foam without acetone. Here are the photos and the dielectric properties of these two samples in the frequency band between 2 and 18 GHz. Results show that the real permittivity of sample with 8% of acetone decreases when the acetone is used. This decrease in permittivity increases the impedance matching between the air and the absorber and interface. At the same time, we keep the same losses, which is ideal to realize an absorber material. Here I present also the dielectric properties of 5 symbols loaded with different concentration of carbon fibers from 0.0125% to 0.075% of carbon fiber. We observe that the permittivities of sample are very close to the permittivity of air, which increases the impedance matching between the air and the absorber. On the other hand, we observe that the losses increases when the concentration of carbon fiber increases. We notice also that the samples show a gradient of losses which allow us to realize a multilayer with an impedance gradient. The simulation of the absorption performance was first done using the CST software and the presented dielectric properties. And the thickness for this simulation is 125 millimeters. This thickness is chosen because it is often used for commercial multilayer absorbers. This simulation predicts a good absorption performance with a reflection coefficient lower than minus 13 dB in all the studied frequency range, which means that more than 95% of acetate waves are absorbed. The multilayer prototype is carried out with these 5 layers, and the measurement of this prototype is done and compared to the simulation and the measurement of commercial absorber. First, we can notice that the measurement of the realized prototype shows a reflection coefficient curve quite similar to the simulated one. Moreover, the absorption performance of our prototype is very close to the performance of the commercial material and slightly better at some frequencies, especially at high frequencies. One can note here that our prototype is very lightly loaded compared to the commercial one, as we can see on these photos. Now I will show you the result of another lightweight and optimized prototype using a program that we developed. This program uses the genetic algorithm optimizer. The new prototype is made with 3 layers and has a total thickness of 90 millimeters. This prototype will be compared to the epoxy prototype and to the commercial absorber with 125 millimeter thickness. In order to better compare this prototype by taking into account their reflection coefficients and their thicknesses, factor of merit was calculated using this formula. Here, this factor is inversely proportional to the linear measured reflection coefficient and to the thickness of the absorber, because we are trying to reduce these two parameters. From these three foam curves, we can say that at low frequencies, we obtain better performance for the epoxy prototype with 125 millimeters, here the blue curve, and at high frequencies, the better performance is obtained with the epoxy prototype of 90 millimeter thicknesses, here in a green curve. Now, if we compare our second prototype with low thicknesses, with the commercial material, we can say that we obtain a comparable performance at low frequencies, even better at high frequencies with our prototype compared to the commercial one. Here is my conclusion. I let you read it, and before finishing, I would like to thank Jérôme Sol for his technical support and all the different organizations for their financial support. Thank you for your attention.